Continuation of the previous lecture, solvable for P. It's the second lecture, solvable for X. Most of the students of BTEC EC and BTEC section B, second semester, these are this model, solvable for X. It is the procedure. Here it's mentioned the procedure, left hand side not solvable into a factor. That means your left hand side, whatever may be the left hand side, you should not factorize this quantity. In that case, you can solve a first order higher degree differential equation in two different models. One is solvable for X and another one is solvable for Y. In this particular lecture, we introduce the concept of solvable for X. When you can write a first order higher degree differential equation first order higher degree equation in that form, X is some function of Y and P, where P stand for dy dx. In that case, the procedure of solving, the step of solving is given here. The first one is differentiate the given equation with respect to Y. First you differentiate this equation with respect to Y. Then the left hand side becomes dx dy, and dx dy is 1 by p. So here I mentioned 1 by p. After differentiation of the function of yp, let me consider it's become yp and dp dy. It should be a function of yp and there should exist some term dp dy. A differential equation of the first order and first degree. The second step, solve for p the derivative equation. To obtain this one, when we solve for p for this equation, you got a solution y is some function of p and c, where c being any arbitrary constant. Find x from the original equation by substituting this value of y. That means you just put the value of y in the given equation, that means this equation. When we substitute this value of y, we obtained in b. Obtained in B in the above, the general parametric solution is given by X and Y. That means X is this, X is given by this. When we substitute the value of Y in terms of P and C, this becomes the only function of P and C, and Y becomes a function of P and C. That should be a solution. General parametric solution is given in X and Y. Sometimes it may be happen that eliminating P, it is not happen for every case. It only happens sometimes. You can eliminate from these two equations, x is some function of p and c and y is some function of p and c. You can easily eliminate this p from these two equations and got the general solution. But most of the cases, you cannot eliminate p from these two equations. In that case, this should be the solution, the parametric solution of the given differential equation. Now we move to take example to clear our concept. This one, first example, solvable for X. It is not mentioned in your question that this question belongs to solvable for X or Y or P. You have to recognize which problem is belongs to the which particular method, solvable for P or solvable for X or solvable for Y. In this class, we just mentioned the solvable for X model. Here is the given question, 4yp square minus 2px plus y equals to 0. You can easily observe that according to your learning of the previous lecture, you cannot factorize this quantity. You should not factorize this quantity because it is quite impossible to factorize this. So in that case, you can write either in terms of y is some function of x and p, or it's some function of x is some function of p and Y. Since we have to learn solvable for X, so here we just write this problem exactly in that form, X equals to 2YP plus Y by 2P. That means we just consider 2PX on the right hand side. Here we write the left hand side 2PX and divide by 2P. It's become 4YP square becomes 2PY and Y becomes Y by 2P. So the second step says you just differentiate according to the possibility of solution. Second step says the differentiating the given equation with respect to y. So here we just differentiate with respect to y of the given equation. Then dx dy, x becomes dx dy. So here we write 1 by p, 2py. When we differentiate y, it's become 1, 2p. And when you differentiate p with respect to y, it's become 2y dp dy. When you differentiate this one, y differentiation is 1. So here we write 1 by p and 1 by 2p differentiation is minus 1 by 2p square dp dy. In the next step, you should remember that every term of dp dy you can write either in the left hand side or in the right hand side. Here it's in this problem, here we write in the right hand side all the term containing dp dy, taking together of any side, either on the left side or on the right side, and the remaining term should write in the opposite side. So here we write in the opposite, left hand side is only the p term or other term which should not consist any dp dy. So it's become 1 by p, 2p is comes from this becomes minus 2p, and 1 by 2p when we move to in the left hand side, it's become minus 1 by 2p. So the result becomes dp dy. If we take dp dy is common, in that case the result becomes 2y minus y by 2b square. You can easily observe that there should be a common term. After calculation, you should get a common term. This one is the common term, 4b square minus of 1. So here we write all the term on the left hand side and take the common 4b square minus of 1. The remaining term should be 1 plus y by p dp dy. It's just a factor. So when we consider this one from this case, we just consider this one equal 1 plus y by p dp dy, and that is equals to 0. Then the result becomes y dp by p dy equals to minus 1. Just we consider the y term in the same place and x term in the same place. Y dp plus p dy equals to 0. It's represent dpy equals to 0. Integrating both sides, we get py equals to c, which is a constant. Substituting according to the procedure, next procedure says, when we find this solution y in terms of function of p and c, in the next step we just put the value of y in the given equation. Okay, so for this problem, when we find y in terms of c by p, just to put the value of y is equals to c by p in equation number 1. Equation number 1, that is the given equation. So here it's become y is this. So when we substitute this result, the result becomes, here we substitute just p equals to c by y, because you can easily eliminate p from these two equation. So here we replace p equals to c by y, it's become c square y square minus 2 c by y x plus y equals to 0, which is your required general solution. But most of the cases you cannot eliminate p in that particular easy manner. For that reason, we move to the next example. Here is another example. The problem is directly in form of the x is some function of y and p. So the first step is you have to differentiate with respect to y, dx becomes dx dy, and y becomes 1, and p square becomes 2p dp dy. So here we write dx dy equals to 1 by p, 1 minus 2p dp dy. Just we write dp dy in the one side of the equation, and another side should be the remaining term. That is 1 minus 2p. Here it is 1 minus 2p. Sorry, 1 minus 1 by p. Just make a calculation, p minus 1 by p, and the calculation, after the calculation, it's become dp dy equals to p minus 1 by 2p square. Just we take dy one side and the another side should contain, it's the method of separation of variable. So dy is the separate variable and p is the another variable. So we just separate y with all the term, or just separate dy with all the term of y and dp with all the term of p. And the calculation here, make a calculation for finding the result of the integration. Here we consider this one p square minus 1 plus 1. So the numerator p square minus 1 divided by p minus 1, it's become p plus 1, and the remaining term is plus 1 by p minus 1. Integrating both sides, we have dy becomes y, p become p square. P become p square by 2, and this becomes only p, and this becomes log mod p minus 1. When we multiply with 2, p square by 2 becomes only p square, p becomes 2p, and this result becomes 2 log p minus of 1 plus c is the integrating constant. And therefore the given equation is therefore the given equation x, if we put the value of y in equation 1, in equation one, that means the given equation y minus of p square, if we put the value of y here, you can easily observe that the result becomes, you can easily observe that the result exactly becomes this 2p plus 2 log p minus of 1 plus c. Eliminating 1 and 2, it's the parametric form. You cannot easily eliminate this p from these two equations, so your result should be 1 and 2 taken together gives the general parametric solution, while the general solution will be given by the p eliminate as well as we obtained from the given equation. That means if we can eliminate this p from these two equations, we got the result, but you cannot eliminate this p. In that case, this one becomes the parametric representation of the required curve which you want to find. So here we use another example to clear your idea clearly. So it's another example, y equals to 2px plus y square pq. Just to make this equation for solvable for x, y equals to y by 2p minus y square by p square. According to the technique, first you differentiate with respect to y both side. Next, again we repeat, just we consider dp dy, all the term dp dy, one side of an equation and another side is the remaining term. It should be happen that a term should be common, and the one term should be common in both the cases. You just take the common term and the remaining part becomes this. You just consider this one equals to 0, and solving this equation we got py equals to c. And in this case, you can easily observe that you can easily substitute the value of p in terms of c and y, that is c by y. If we put this value of p c by y in the given equation, we get y equals to c 2cx by y plus y square c by y the whole cube, that is y square 2cx plus c cube, as the general solution of the given equation. The parametric solution, you can easily write the parametric solution, it's a general solution, you can easily find the general solution, but still you can find the parametric solution also. Here if we can write y is equals to c by p, and x, if we put in a given equation the value of y in terms of c and p, it's become this, that should be the parametric solution of the given equation. It's another example. You can solve this example with the help of this lecture, and I think you can easily solve this problem. If you face any kind of problem, you can easily call me, feel free to contact with me. That is another example. That's your homework. Okay, thank you for listening, and wait for the next lecture. We will move in the next lecture, solvable for y. There is a special case which is known as the Cariot's form. So wait for the next lecture. Thank you.